Welcome to ASU Spotlight. I'm Kerry Pfeffer. ASU Spotlight is a program aimed at highlighting the significant contributions of different schools and programs at Arizona State University. Since the Biodesign Institute's opening in December 2004, it has quickly become an internationally recognized research facility. Here, scientists from a wide range of disciplines work in teams to take on big challenges currently affecting human health and quality of life. The goal is to provide solutions for real-world problems, such as developing new sources of energy and minimizing our impact on the environment. We begin with a problem that grows more apparent each year, our need for renewable energy.
Next time you go to the pump, consider this. It took millions of years for nature to create the world's oil supply, and only about 100 years to significantly deplete it. Clearly, nature can't keep pace with human demand, making this a non-renewable energy source.
We're taking it out of the ground, we're burning it, and we're releasing it into the atmosphere. What we need to do in order to create a sustainable system, a system that we can perpetuate forever, is we need to create a cycle.
Neal Woodbury is director of the Center for Biooptical Nanotechnology at ASU's Biodesign Institute, where researchers are partnering with nature in creating a sustainable fuel.
So we let biology do what it does well, take sunlight, create a fuel out of it. Normally it uses sugar and fat, basically. And so we want to create those kinds of sugars and fats from the using biology and then convert them into a form that's good for us.
This flask could hold the answer. It's full of billions of cyanobacteria, single-celled organisms that thrive on water and sunlight. Only this has been specially engineered to have large amounts of fat called lipids.
Here is a close-up of one of those cells. And inside those cells, there are membranes, so very thin lipid protein bilayers. And each of those membranes is composed of essentially 50% lipids, and then those lipids can be easily converted into biodiesel.
The bacteria's high proportion of fat provides an advantage over other biofuel sources like corn or sugarcane, and they reproduce quickly, doubling every 12 hours, faster than any plant can grow.
And these cyanobacteria have the advantage that they can be grown in completely non-arable land. I mean, they can be grown on the rooftop, they could be grown over a freeway, they could be grown in the desert where we're not doing any farming, and therefore they're not competing with the food industry.
The lipids produced by the cyanobacteria could be converted into biodiesel with very little processing, offering another major advantage over other methods. The research team is constructing a small-scale bioreactor test project this year, and within 2 years, hope to be able to fund a larger scale pilot that would be as long as a football field and twice as wide.
What the real attraction of this work is that you can take CO2 out of the air, one of the greenhouse gases, you're making fuels out of it, and those you can put into the car, we will generate the same amount of greenhouse gases again.